leagues, all of them, including the NBA, are in bed with gambling now. They've embraced it. They've said, the leagues have said,
100% of everybody who watches basketball thinks the same thing. And the fact that the NBA keeps trying to protect the same one entity is ridiculous.
See what you've done? I don't know who you are. I don't know where you are, but you may want to start changing your ways.
Okay, so he's going to go for a rebound, right? And no matter what, we are calling a foul.
Really? Why?
Because I need a hip replacement. That's why.
Okay.
The hell is not going to pay for itself. Screw him. He can suck on this baguette.
Suck on my blur.
I got money on the game. Deal, y'all? Mm-hmm. We on the same page? Mm-hmm. All right, break.
Word.
Alrighty then.
I need to stop acting like a buffoon because, honestly, this can affect the NBA. It could be a very serious matter. It can affect the integrity of the game, and Lord knows we wouldn't want that. I mean, the NBA already has other problems that they have to deal with. Yeah, I don't know, dude. Like, yeah, now I'm sad. I'm sad, dude. Because I love the game so much, and I wouldn't want nothing like this to negatively impact the game. But you know what? Let's get on with the report, y'all. As we all know, the NBA fined center Rudy Gobert $100,000 after he suggested that the league's officials were influenced by gamblers, also known as regular people, during and after the 113-104 overtime loss to the Cavaliers on Friday. The league said in a statement Sunday that the unusually large fine, quote, takes into account of Gobert's past instances of contract detrimental to the NBA, with regard to publicly criticizing the officiating.
Stop the cap.
Yeah, I don't believe it. I don't believe it. That's a bunch of hot sauce. Somebody please, please, eject the freaking executive that released that statement, because this $100,000 fine is substantially larger than any of freaking Draymond's assassination attempts. Well, I mean, he got suspended, so that probably hurt him even more, honestly. But according to reports, like mine, this was the largest fine of the season that wasn't related to a suspension. I believe that the league handed this hefty fine because they wanted to send a message to the league saying, don't toss this narrative out there for people to buy. If this starts percolating around the league, it can severely hurt the integrity of the league. People will lose interest in the league. Old heads will start yammering even more. Youngins will get dissuaded and probably start watching the freaking WNBA. Yeah, on second thought, dude, I think the NBA will be just fine. I think the NBA will just be just fine. But please do note that I have a WNBA rant coming out in the next couple of days. But you know what? Let's get on with this report. Screw that report. Gobert admitted during the post-game interview that this gesture that he did was immature, but he added that he believes that the gambling part is hurting, in his words, hurting the game. He also said that, I know the betting and all that is becoming bigger and bigger, but it shouldn't feel that way, he said. I mean, there could be all other aspects, negative aspects, shall I say, from the betting side, from the betting aspect, that can negatively impact the game. I mean, like, personal disagreements that can alter games all too well, and add in some financial incentives, and ladies and gentlemen, you have a recipe for disaster. I mean, we all know the CP3 Scott Brooks fiasco. Let's have Uncle Gil explain it a bit more here. Uncle, please. Listen.
I'm sorry. Like, you look stupid as an organization. The same one person who is showing that he's favoritism against Chris Paul. The fact that you still have this entity in the NBA, there's 100% of the people believe he's cheating.
The NBA already has like a notorious incident in the past. I mean, They've pretty much done their very best to wipe it off clean from their history. This Tim Donaghy fiasco, or whatever the hell, I don't even want to go too deep into it. I mean, everybody knows about it. People don't know is that, I mean, Scott Foster was not directly involved, but there was some correlation, I guess. I don't know. Correlation, quote unquote, that had his name all around the reports. I mean, apparently he made more by him. I mean, Tim Donaghy made more than 100 phone calls to Foster during the 2006-2007 season. But Foster, a 30-year NBA veteran, said the games were not, said his calls were not related to the gambling scandal at all, and he was not charged with the crime. But, you know, let's just take that as we will. But here's the thing. I am not completely reporting that betting is all that bad for the game. It's probably, honestly, introducing a new group of people to the game. People who weren't interested in the game, but interested in the aspect of betting. I would not be surprised if it brought a huge new audience. It makes people, schmucks like us, feel more involved. Like, and listen, we already have the league partnering with goddamn freaking betting apps out the ass. I feel like there's a new betting app made every single Tuesday night. Like, it's getting out of hand, but you know what? It's not just the NBA. It's every league. Heck, even YouTube channels like me. I don't want to sound like a freaking hypocrite, like, because Lord knows that if a betting app were to sponsor me, newborn activity will kick in. And my sorry ass would jump on it the moment it freaking introduced. Like, welcome to another episode of The Dirty Bucket, sponsored by FanDuel. FanDuel, please use 20% off your next purchase, your betting purchase, using the code FLOPDON'TLIE. And you know what? FanDuel, where you, the people, run the league. Let's be honest, this problem, this minuscule problem right now, but it could be brought to light even larger, is not only affecting the NBA, it's affecting other leagues, like the NFL.
Hey, these seats taken? Feel free.
But the Dirty Bucket covers the NBA, so the NFL means nothing to me. Go Commanders. But also, on another level, I feel like people really haven't thought of this aspect of this fiasco. I mean, some players, they don't really care about the game as much anymore. I mean, look at Zion and Ben Simmons. Sorry, my asthma freaking flares up whenever I say that heathen's name, but you know what? We shall continue. Who is to say that the money-hungry players starts giving up on games to start getting more money on the side? The love for the game is dissipating. And I think that's another problem that the NBA needs to solve. But I'll cover that on another video. I think those three arguments, along with a sketchy past, are, I guess, somewhat arguments that can be used in the possible new cheating problem that the NBA has. And again, I'm not saying that I want the NBA to happen. Like, I don't want, obviously as a fan, I don't want none of this to be included in the NBA. I want the best player, the best teams to get the limelight because of their own talent, not because of freaking what some freaking cuck has to do with the freaking call in the game. No. You know, I want honest basketball play. And it's sad that I'm actually saying that. I'm over here freaking in Maryland saying, I want honest basketball play. No, like, I'm getting out of hand. But let me know what you guys think. There's a lot to unfold in this debauchery. Am I a buffoon for reporting this and saying this out loud? Am I a buffoon? I could be a buffoon, dude. I could be a buffoon. You know, if you like the video, please like and subscribe. I would really, really appreciate it. I want to hit our goal of 13 subscribers. It's a pretty lofty goal, but you know what? It is what it is. I'll see you on the next video, y'all. I really appreciate y'all watching the video. Probably the next video that I'm working on is this WNBA rants report that I got working on, but you know what? Probably be on the next couple days. But you know what? It is what it is. I'll see y'all. Take care. Peace, y'all.
Klutz, I get so nervous when I gamble. I'm so silly. Oh.
2 words. Tim Donaghy.